Hello, welcome to ISTQB Foundation Level Syllabus, and today we are going to discuss about the last review technique, that is the prospective based review technique, and we will also see that how it is different from the role based review technique. So let's start with our topic, and first what we will see is about the reviewer. So here the reviewer will act like a different stakeholder, whereas in role based technique he was behaving like a stakeholder, like a single stakeholder, but here he is behaving like a different stakeholders. So that is what is one difference between the prospective based and the role based review technique. Second thing what we will see is about the process. What process a reviewer will follow? The reviewer will evaluate the work product from the perspective of different stakeholders. So how a different stakeholder will behave, and according to that he will review the work product. Let's see the different stakeholders in that particular scenario. So for the preparation, he will be behaving like a role of a stakeholder as a user, marketing, designer and tester. So he will see that this particular product, how it will be used by the stakeholders like user. So how the user is going to use this. And if it is going to the marketing people, then how the marketing people will be using this particular product. If designer is using this product, then how he will be behaving and what will be the behavior of the tester when he is using this particular product. So he will be behaving like all this person, and with that critical thinking he will be reviewing your work product. So that is why here he will be behaving like a different roles, and based on that role he will be asking you the questions. So that is how it is different from the role based technique. There the reviewer will act as a one role, will have a one role, and he will act like that, and he will do the review process according to that. But here he will be acting like a different person, different stakeholders, and then he will be reviewing your work product. Then the success factor will obviously depend upon how well he has understood the product based on the different stakeholders. So how the user will use this work product. So he has to understand that. If he understood that properly, then that will be helpful in this particular process, and likewise for the other. So with this we are completing our review based techniques. So I will see you in my next video. Until then, happy testing.